Hello, I'm Mr. Harniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Nanak was not a guru, he was a Satguru. Hardly anybody knows that he was a Satguru. They just say Guru, Guru, Guru. Guru means a rabbi, a Brahman. So you can see what type of knowledge they have in Sikhism. And here I'm rendering exposition of St. Luke, chapter 12, verse 1 to 5. Meanwhile, when the crowd gathered in thousands, oh, that's quite a great number, so that they trampled on one another, he began to speak first to his brethren, laborers, the inner circle, you know, 12. And not the once-born disciples of the rabbis. Now, this word disciple has been introduced by the Messianic Jews who bring in their old temple practices, the Jewish leaven. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. Was fulfilled in them. So beware of the yeast of the Pharisee. Yeast of the Pharisee mean the letters, the scripture, they are milk, and we are fed meat, the flesh of Jesus, juicy meat, and these are the ear to eat that flesh of Jesus. Milk is by the brain. You have to remember the letters, you know, scriptures. That's why they used to have competition, quoting verses from this and that. And when they were memorizing all these things, they had no capacity to think themselves. What is written, they will vomit it out quick. And gospel is not vomiting out. It is by grace. And those people who receive it by grace, they explain it in detail what it means. So beware of the yeast of the Pharisee. That is their hypocrisy as today. You have these hireling dog-collared priests in churches, which are men of letters, no spirit, working in the churches, and the politicians who hate the bitter pill of gospel, but they give sugar-coated tablets of falsehoods that bring in votes for their election. So they want to be elected, they must say everything sweet. No speck of bitter. Gospel is bitter. Only the falsehoods are sweet. So you can see if you speak falsehood, then where will you land up? In Sikhism, it is stated that falsehood kills people in thousands, millions. As you can see them in happening in Middle East now, Christian, Muslim, they have been given this, outwardly they have become Christian, Muslim, whereas Christian, Muslim is a spiritual self, inwardly, not outwardly. So they are killing each other like hell. Nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not be, that will not become known. Remember that when Jesus was at the Samaritan village, John 4, the Samaritan woman, she told Jesus that you are a prophet. And she tells again that there is a greater than prophet is Christ. When Christ comes, he will tell us everything. And that is what it means, you know, nothing secret that will not become known. So if you think logically, logical reasoning is the tool to dig out the treasures of our fathers. So logical reasoning done with the power of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit with small s is a common sense. And Holy Spirit with capital S is extraordinary sense. That is of God, you know. The spirit of man is with small s. Spirit of God is with capital S. So common sense, we call it surti in Punjabi, bears fruit in total. I have written an ebook on Kindle with the power of Holy Spirit, common sense, that the men of letters have no clue. Men of letters, they copy here and there, but gospel is through revelations, and that is through Holy Spirit, is the tool that reveals. So gospel is also said to be buried in a field, and the one who found the treasures, he covered them up, went home, sold all his property to buy that field, because these treasures are only given to those who have been predestined, who long for gospel. Therefore, whatever you have said in the dark will be heard in the light. That means dark means you have what, whenever you hear something, you have a chance to ponder over it. Now, after pondering, you know, then you know that, this is the truth, you know. Now, you know the truth, but you may be frightened to speak the truth. That is wrong. Jesus said, will be heard in the light. In the light means will be proclaimed from the rooftop. Nothing to worry about. For example, a Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Jew is a spiritual self. So during the Holocaust, not a single Jew died in Germany. But people of Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, and Judah tribe, all these tribal people died. They were born, they died. That is called blind man leading the blind into the pit. That is what they are. So if a politician or a these doctor person happen to proclaim that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, all the people will jump at him. And he will not get vote. If he is a doctor priest, he'll be thrown out of the church immediately. That is the power of the gospel. So to stay in their post, they have to give sugar-coated tablets of falsehoods, and they kill people. And what you have whispered behind closed doors will be proclaimed from the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not fear those who kill the body. You know, this body, you die, you know, for preaching gospel. So they do not be frightened of them who kill it. And after that, can do nothing more. They can't touch your soul. They can't touch your conscience. So your mind carries all the credit. And when you are born again, then the reward is there for speaking the gospel truth in the previous life. But I will warn you whom to fear. Fear him who, after he has killed, has authority to cast you into hell. Yes, I tell you, fear him. Remember, in the case of Lazarus, a rich man also died, Lazarus died. Rich man was greedy and he cheated people to become rich. And he entered into the hell. Lazarus, righteous person, son of Abraham, he landed in the lap of Abraham, a righteous person. So it is our Father you have to fear, who you put your soul into next rebirth, into a lower or higher type of birth. That means all these living things, they have the soul in them. And the human birth is the best. And this is the opportunity for you to meet our Father, God, our supernatural Father. And those who don't take advantage of this opportunity, they are die, born again, and again dark age will come like this we have today. Again Christ will come, and then again people will be have chance to have rest in the fold of our Father. And where is this resurrection? That means you become like Father, eternal, no more born again and death. With this, I will leave it. Our Father God, bless you.